I'm walking along the canal side in a place called Summertown, which is on the north end of Oxford. And although the place is a nice fancy housing estate now, it used to be the site of a brickworks. And in 1870, in the brickworks that used to be over there in one of the clay pits, the men working there found a fantastic discovery. They discovered a dinosaur. So the fossils found in Summertown Clay Works were bought by James Parker, a local bookseller and amateur geologist, and he sent them on to John Phillips, who was the first curator of the Oxford University Natural History Museum. These fossils were briefly looked at and then put into storage and largely forgotten about. 20 years later, in 1890, Arthur Woodward re-examined the fossils and thought it was a species of Megalosaurus. This creature had a lot of similarities with the fossils that were found of Megalosaurus earlier in the 1800s. Then a man by the name of Baron Franz Nopcsa also took a look at them in 1905 and reassigned them to a species that had been found in France called Streptospondylus. Now, this proved controversial at the time, as the fossil remains of Streptospondylus from France were very, very poor quality. They were just a handful of vertebrae and not in very well preserved shape either. So there was some controversy at the time, particularly as the fossil from Summertown was almost complete. It was an almost complete animal. So if anything, it should have been the other way around. In 1964, Alec Walker re-examined the find and noticed some similarities between the Oxford fossil and Streptospondylus, but also noticed a few differences in it, and he gave it the name that we currently know it today, Eustreptospondylus. So what kind of creature was Eustreptospondylus? Well, the fossil that was found in Summertown was that of a subadult, so wasn't quite fully grown, and the fossil is about 4.5 meters long. It's thought that a fully grown adult would have been about 6 meters. Now, the meaning of the name, Eustreptospondylus, cracking name, let's be honest, it means true-turned vertebra, basically referring to the position of the vertebra and how they were turned backwards on going down the body of the animal. And its species name, Oxoniensis, just refers to the fact that it was found in Oxfordshire. So when did Eustreptospondylus live? Well, it's from about 166 million years ago, from an age called the Calovian, in the middle of the Jurassic period. And it was found in a rock formation called the Oxford Clay. It's a sedimentary rock made up mostly from mudstone that is of a shallow marine origin. Now, the paleo environments, the environment that Eustreptospondylus lived in, was that of a series of small islands surrounded by a warm, shallow sea. And this environment covered most of Europe at the time. There's a very good chance that Eustreptospondylus was a decent swimmer, island hopping in search of food as it was going around. Now, where does it sit in the family tree of dinosaurs? Well, it's part of the suborder of dinosaurs called theropods. That's the meat-eating dinosaurs. And it's part of the family called the Megalosauridae. So it's actually quite closely related to Megalosaurus, which you saw in the previous episode. But it is a much more graceful predator, a lot smaller, and has been put into a subfamily called the Eustreptospondylinae. And as a little side note, one of the things that makes Eustreptospondylus so special is the fact that when it was discovered in 1870, it was the most complete theropod found anywhere in the world. And if you just compare on these diagrams the finds of Megalosaurus with Eustreptospondylus, you'll see what I mean. Megalosaurus was a substantial find. There's a considerable amount of the skull, along with the hip, hind legs, vertebra, and a few other bits and pieces. But if you look at Eustreptospondylus, you've got an almost complete skeleton. You're only missing parts of the forelimbs, some of the ribs, the odd vertebra, and the jaw. Now, there have been other fossil theropods found throughout the world, many of them more complete than you, Streptospondylus. But even still today, it represents the most complete large theropod found within Europe from the middle of the Jurassic. And for that, it is most definitely worthy of a special mention.